Shlomo HaMelech, King Solomon, the smartest person that God ever created, writes in his book, the Book of Mishlei. He said, Lech el nemala atzel, re'ei drachea v'chakem. In other words, lazy, go to the ant and learn your ways, and you learn how to conduct your life. We know that an ant lives for 6 months. During the 6 months, how much could she eat? A crumb, crumb and a half, that's it. Yet she's collecting so much, enough to live for a couple of years. And then comes the question, why does she do it? What's the... She's not going to have anything out of it. And the answer is, this little ant thinks to himself, maybe God will prolonger my life for a couple of years, so I should have enough what to eat for the next couple of years. This little hope makes her to walk non-stop. She never sits still. She goes around and walks and walks and walks. And that's what Shlomo HaMelech, King Solomon, meant. Lech el nemala atzel, you lazy, go learn from the hand. Go collect mitzvot and good things as long that you have the strength. And therefore, a Jew have to always look and say, and never say, oh, I do enough mitzvahs. I do enough good things. It's not enough. Never say it's enough. It's never enough what I did yesterday, like this ant. Never enough she collected yesterday. Today is another day. A Jew today has to add one mitzvah and another mitzvah and on. This week's parasha, we're learning Parshat Beshalach. We're starting with Vayi Beshalach Paro et Ha'am. Finally, God got us out of Egypt. Our sages tell us that this incident from going out of Egypt is not something that happened a few thousand years ago. בכל דור ודור חייב אדם לראות את עצמו כאילו הוא יצא ממצרים. A person, every generation and generation, has to feel like he was the one that went out from Mitzrayim. The Baal HaTanya, in his book of Tanya, chapter 47, says, not only every single generation, every single day and day, person has to feel like today he went out of Egypt. In other words, the going out of Egypt is not something that happened 3,300 years ago and that's it. No. Every single day a person has to go out from Mitzrayim. Mitzrayim in Hasidut means Meitzarim, limitations. If you yesterday like today, you limit it, you're in Mitzrayim. So every single day a person has to go out of Mitzrayim. And here comes the question, how do we explain it? We went out from Mitzrayim yesterday. Isn't that enough? We went out the day before. Every single day we have to go out of Egypt. And the answer is yes. Every single day a person can change. Every single day person has to go up with his level. What I did yesterday was enough for yesterday, but it's not enough for today. Today I have to get further, continue. I have to know that what happened yesterday is not enough. And this one we learn from the hand. It's not enough the food that I got yesterday. Today she needs more. Though whatever she had yesterday was enough for yesterday. To understand it better, the Lubavitcher Rebbe, people used to go for dollars to get a dollar every Sunday, the Rebbe used to give out dollars. One of his common blessings that he used to bless people, I wish you, you should not be happy with your part. You should not be happy b'chalko. Which means to say, we know our sages tell us, Ezeu asher, who is considered rich, asameach b'chalko, someone that is happy with his part. Which means, that the Rebbe interpreted, means, I have a house, I have a car, I have a family, whatever God gave me, I have to be happy. If I'm happy, I'm the richest person in the world. This is when it comes to physical life, it comes to spiritual life. Never enough. Never say, whatever I do till now is perfect. The mitzvah that I did till today is perfect. The amount of learning that I did till today, it's enough. I don't have to learn more. No, never enough. Whatever you learned yesterday, whatever you did yesterday was good for yesterday. Today, yeah, we have to be even better. Never say, I wish a lot of people would do what I did. No, never enough. That's the way the Rebbe demanded from himself, and that's the way the Rebbe is demanding from us. Let's hope and pray that since this Shabbat is Shabbat that we went out from Mitzrayim, from exile, let's hope that very soon we'll go out from our exile to the redemption with Moshiach together. Shabbat Shalom.